Good everyone, my name is Alex and welcome to another TV Box review. For today I have a TV Box that a lot of you are asking about. I have the Alphawise H96 Pro Plus. And yeah, I've been waiting for this for close to 2 months, so a long, long time. For specs, we have the Amlogic S912, we have 3 GB of RAM, we have 32 GB of internal storage, dual band Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. The H96 Pro Plus comes in a black box. We don't really have any information of the box except for the model name that's on the front. Inside the box, you're gonna find the usual stuff. So the device itself, you're also gonna find an HDMI cable, you're gonna find a power adapter, and this is the same power adapter that we've seen in the past. The remote control, and once again, this is the exact same remote control that we've seen for many, many TV boxes. And yes, I do recommend using a wireless keyboard and mouse for a much better experience. And aside from that, you're gonna find the user manual. The user manual, it's in English and it's got a couple of pictures. Price-wise, this costs between $70 and $80 depending when and where you buy it from, but it looks just like any other TV box, so on the outside you don't really see anything special. So it is made out of plastic entirely. On the front we have the model name, which is the H96 Pro Plus, and the brand name. On the right hand side we have a slot for an SD card, and since this device is using Android 6, you can easily install an SD card as internal storage. And speaking about internal storage, out of the 32 gigs of internal storage that we get, we actually have about 26 free. The speeds that I got for the internal storage are very, very good. Moving on the other side of the device, you're gonna find the only 2 USB ports. And lastly, on the back, you're gonna find the port for the power adapter, you're gonna find the AV out, the HDMI, and the optical audio. And since we are talking about the optical audio, I tried DTS sound and Dolby Digital sound for Kodi, and it does work very, very good. So I'm very happy to say that this, just like the Alphawise S92, works very good with DTS sound and Dolby Digital sound. And there is also a network adapter port on the back of this box. As I mentioned before, we have dual band Wi-Fi, and I checked the speeds over Wi-Fi and over a wired connection, and the speeds that I got are among the best that I have ever seen for any TV box, any phone or anything like that. Of course, I checked this in the middle of the night, so I believe it was like 1:30 a.m. So maybe the network wasn't that congested, but yes, the speeds that I got over the 2.4, the 5 and the through a wired connection are really, really good. Since Miracast is also related to the internet connection, I've checked Miracast and I was able to connect my phone to the TV box, and it does seem to work very good. And I'm sure that everybody is curious to see the benchmark results. So I've done the Antutu benchmark, I've done the Geekbench 4 and the iStorm Extreme. The scores that I got are appropriate for the S912 CPU, but they aren't anything special. So we've seen higher scores on the Billing GT1, if I remember correctly. And of course there is Bluetooth connectivity as well, and the Bluetooth connectivity works good. I was able to connect a Bluetooth controller and play a whole bunch of games on this box without any issues. Now that you've seen how this looks, we've seen the benchmark results, the speeds over Wi-Fi and over a wired connection, I'm gonna start recording the screen, I'm gonna show you how the launcher looks, and we'll check out and see how well this performs. This is the launcher that we get. The first thing I notice is the fact that we have the navigation bar at the bottom of the screen, so you can hide this and then you can bring it back up. And we also have the notification tab on top. Let's start by checking out what apps come pre-installed. So we have a whole bunch of apps right here. We have this app right here that's called Go Live. The movie player, we have Netflix, we have the Play Store, Miracast right there. And the YouTube app. Some of the apps that you see here I actually installed myself. The settings app looks identical to the settings app that we've seen in the past for many TV boxes. A network here you can either connect through the Wi-Fi or through a cable. A display, you can change the screen resolution, and this may be different depending on the TV that you have connected to the box. And for the duration of this video, the HDR will be turned off. And moving to sounds, here you can change the digital sounds. And as I mentioned before, DTS sound and Dolby Digital sound work very good with Kodi, so no issues there. And moving to about here, here at about we can see the model name. So we have the model H96 Pro Plus. And the latest security patch is coming from August 1st, 2016. Moving to languages, so we have a whole bunch of languages available, like most of these Android TV boxes. So it was a bit difficult to scroll with the mouse. But definitely a whole bunch of languages available here as well.
And moving back, we also have HDMI CEC. This is basically a function that turns off the TV whenever you turn on the TV box, or turns on the TV whenever you turn on the TV box. So it's very useful. And as I mentioned before, we do have Bluetooth connectivity. For those of you that are wondering, we have root access from the factory, and this is the digital rights management information that we get. And since we are here, I can tell you that the Play Store also works very good. So I haven't had any issues with any app from the Play Store. So you can just click on any game and basically install it. So no issues whatsoever with the Play Store. For the YouTube app, I was able to get a maximum resolution of 1080p. Keep in mind that this may be different depending on the TV that you have connected to the TV box. And as you can probably tell, 1080p does go extremely smooth without any issues. Before we go any further, I just wanted to touch on the multitasking. So I did have a whole bunch of apps open in the background. All these apps are running in the background. And it seems that the TV box is keeping them open and it doesn't close them. So definitely that 3 gigs of RAM that we have, it's very useful for multitasking. So all the apps that we have running in the background will stay running in the background. For Kodi, the H96 Pro Plus comes pre-installed with Kodi 16.1. However, there is an update in the Google Play Store, and this would bring Kodi to version 17. However, I don't like version 17, so I'm going to continue the video with the version 16. So for Kodi, I'm just going to go to System and System Info here. I'm just going to show you some information that we see here. So we have 1.6 gigs of available RAM at this particular time. So this is all the information that we get here. And I'm just going to show you what add-ons we have pre-installed. So there are some add-ons that come pre-installed. And these ones are all the ones that we get. So quite a few, in fact. And I'm just going to find, let's see if we can find a working one. So let's try this one here. And of course, as you are expecting, Kodi does work very good if you find a working stream. So a good thing that we have a whole bunch of add-ons pre-installed. Since we already have Kodi opened, I'm gonna start opening a couple of these files that I have from here. I tried some of them already, and most of them seem to work very good. So as you can probably tell, this one works good. Moving on to the next one, which is a 4K. No, let's try this one first before the 4K one. This one also works good, so we'll stop this one and we'll move to a 4K file at 59 frames per second. And this one also works good, and that's something that I was expecting. And the next one, it's another 4K file at 50 frames per second. So after the first second or so, it does seem to work very smooth as well. So most files except for one will work on this. So I'm going to open this 720p file here. I'm just going to skip forward. And of course, it works great. We'll stop this and we'll move to the next one. This is the next one. We'll skip all the way to the end. And of course, most files, as I said before, will work very good. This is the following one that I'm going to try. And as you're expecting, it does work really good. The next file, it's going to be another 4K file filmed with my phone. This is at 24 frames per second. And yes, it does work good. And the only one that's not going to work, it's this one. And I'm not sure how this is called or where I got it from. I know that if we actually try the MX player, it will work on most TV boxes. And this is going to be the last file that we'll try. So definitely most files that you're going to try on the H96 Pro Plus will work very good. Because we have 3 gigs of RAM, this is going to be very good for gaming. So there are a whole bunch of games in the Google Play Store that you could play on this. And I played 3 games so you can see how well it does. The first one, it's GTA San Andreas, and I played at the maximum settings.
Roll out. out of here now.
And as you've seen, GTA works really, really good. The following game that I played was Real Racing 3. And as you can probably tell already, this one also works very good. And the last game that I tried was FIFA 16, and of course, as you'd expect, this one also worked very good. And it's time to conclude this video. So after I've been using this for a day and a half, I have to say that it is my favorite TV box and probably the best that I tried until now. I think that Zedoo X9S was a bit more polished. However, price comparison, that one is double the price. So this one is basically the best TV box under 80 bucks that you can buy. So I do recommend this TV box. If you don't like the launcher, you have a whole bunch of launchers available in the Play Store, as you can probably see here, so you can install any launcher that you want. All the apps are working great. I haven't had a single app crashing or anything like that, so all the apps work really good. The speeds over Wi-Fi were very good. Downloading movies and stuff like that works extremely good. So I'm very, very pleased with this TV box. One of the best TV boxes that I have tried. Alright guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did like it, press that like button. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.